We are here in Austin, Texas, capital of the Lone Star State. And today we are doing the Onion Creek Metropolitan Park Trail. We're gonna do some side trails along the way, such as the Greenbelt Trail and the Knuckles Crossing Trail. I apologize if I butchered that name. Temperature is currently reading 99 degrees as of September 15th, 2024, Sunday. And we are ready to go. Should come out to over 4 miles, combining those two smaller trails with this one that we're doing. And it is hot.
It's very hot. But it looks like mostly going to be in the shade, hopefully.
Yep.
So use lots of sunscreen and drink lots of water.
Yes. Do not underestimate the weather, folks. No matter the conditions. All right.
Here we go.
Should be a relatively easy walk and prepare us for tomorrow's hike, which we will be doing the Bull Creek Trail. This one is rated as easy, and the Bull Creek is rated as moderate with some uphill, but plenty of shade, and supposedly there's a creek to not miss out on. Hopefully it's there by the time we get there. Coming up at about a week in Texas so far. A little over a week for my parents and I, who were not able to make this walk today, but they will be with us hopefully tomorrow, if not soon, as we all prepare for the final big event of this year. Conquer the coast. Mary will be running on support, and I'll mention that again when we begin the ride. And we look forward to it. Trail wants us to go this way. Kind of, not that I've ever been to India, but I've seen plenty of documentaries on it. Kind of looks and feels like it.
Gives you the vibe.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All the scenes that you see about, like, tigers roaming the forests and, you know, the Asian elephants and and the rhinos. Yeah. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if, I think it was at San Antonio Zoo, where if the tiger there escaped, I wouldn't be surprised if it settled into this place or places like this. Plenty of pigs for it to eat. Look at these cacti.
Pokey plants.
Big doggo. Hey, buddy. Here's where we're going to loop around to, on the left. We are going to go this way. And then somewhere up ahead, not too far, is where we're going to break off to the right to do the Greenbelt trail. Thank you. So this is the start of the Greenbelt Trail. It's going to be very short, but just to show you guys as much of Onion Creek as we can, let's do it. Cacti.
A little bit of a climb.
Mm-hmm.
Just have to watch your step.
Cool. See that up ahead?
More cactus and something.
Mm-hmm.
Watch your head.
Okay. Thank you. Looks like there's a kind of a field of them.
Oh, you have some fruit.
I see.
You see the cactus fruit?
Yeah. I wonder what those taste like.
Should we pick some and try?
I'm sure we can use some water to clean them off.
I have no idea how to try cactus fruit. There was a bird who just got in the wind.
What are those over there?
Oh, there's lots of cactus out here.
Yeah. I want to know how the animals eat those.
Warning, I just walked over there.
Oh, okay. Well, you know the spiders down here are not to be made friends with.
Okay.
Well, because they're spiders. Well, spiders are not made to be made friends with either way. What the heck? Aren't you? I'll give him credit, that's a little creative. Lots of cactus fruit. These bushes are kind of scrubbing against our ankles, huh?
Yeah, breathwork.
Yeah.
Right. Lots of bugs.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa, look at this. Right?
Wow.
They're huge. Wow, that's a lot of fruit.
You guys a close up of the cactus fruit. Oh, hey, look, there's a little friend right here. On one of them, he's like, I claim this. Well, okay, it's yours, buddy. You can tell nobody really comes up this trail.
No, I don't think so.
Yeah. Oh man, that's a bad day. People were running through here in like a panic or something. Oh.
It didn't get stuck on me, did it?
I don't know. But to get hit by one of those, oof. I'm gonna veer off to the left somewhere up here.
Yeah.
Right here. Back to the metro trail. Yeah, the grasshoppers, crickets, you know, bugs keep flying toward Mary. That's why she's flinching like that. Good thing she's out front and not me. Is that salt? Or is it just dust?
it's not salt. It's clay. Yeah. Some type of clay
form. I was thinking something like, you know, in Salt Lake.
Minerals. Clay.
Nice quarry. Good place to go shooting if it wasn't next to a trail or a populated area. Check the map. Yep, we go that way. Take us back to the metro trail. Right. So cool.
Cicadas.
We go this way. We are back on the metro trail.
It gets so loud.
Yeah. My dad used to tell me that sometimes they would keep him up at night. Well, there's the creek. It's probably where the doggo was.
Yeah, but you don't want your doggos drinking that.
No. Nope.
Get them sick. Where's the onions?
careful.
Wait, we're pausing right here?
Yep. Hmm? Okay. What? Oh shit.
Oh my god, my feet are getting all wet.
Oh god.
No, he had like some kind of cloth or shirt. Like covering himself right here.
Homeless?
He looked like he's homeless.
Damn it, I didn't see him.
He was laying on the ground. I didn't see him at first too until you were just standing right there.
Mm-hmm.
And I turned because I saw movement. I was looking, you know, across at the water, and all of a sudden I saw movement in the corner of my eye, and I turned, and there he was laying on the ground.
I realized it was something when, the way you said babe, the second time I looked over and I saw your face. I just wasn't trying to, you know, wasn't trying to panic or anything, but yeah, I realized what you were talking about. Like there's, I knew there was someone over there, but I didn't know the condition he was in.
He was, all I could see his full body exposure,
mm-hmm.
except for this area.
Oh my god.
He had like something covering his head. And he had his hand like this.
Freaking homeless.
The one thing I noticed about the trail while we were walking, lots of beer cans and cups.
Mm-hmm.
And like and beer cases tossed. Did you notice that too? Maybe you didn't because you were focused on recording.
Yeah, I should have though. Damn it. Okay, well, people unfortunately, like
drinking on this trail and throwing trash.
We have to go back that way. But
well, we just have to.
I'm fully aware now what is over there.
Yeah.
So
it's okay. We just have to be.
Yeah, you just stay close to me. I'll go first, and then, yeah.
Well, he's right there by the tree,
mm-hmm.
laying down.
Okay. Noted. So we are in fact gonna cut out the Knuckles Crossing part of this walk. The sun's going down, we're gonna have to pick up the pace a little bit because we do not want to be going back when there's no light through that area, through the creek area where that dude is at. But that's okay. It's about safety, folks.
Wow, beautiful trees.
Yeah.
Area.
And we're still enjoying this walk. It is a great place, but just bear in mind, folks, that there can be stuff like that out here or out at any trail. It's interesting, back there when we were trekking through the jungle looked a lot like India. And then the creek part, in my opinion, looked like something like South America or the Amazon. Now it looks like we're in Africa. Watch out for leopards.
Traveling around the world.
Yeah. Like last year in November, I think it was, in Chambers Creek Bay, that trail looked like we were in Ireland. We go right. I just saw that. They're still there. Just saw some deer up here, folks. There they go. Off to the left. I know you guys won't be able to see it, but yeah. A lot of horse manure on this part of the trail, folks. There's the creek off to your right. Mm-hmm. You can hear it flowing a little bit. What do we have here? Old water hose right here.
Yeah. Strange. There's some, like a hose right there, or a rope.
Okay, well, you're right here. Wow. long way from home. So as you can see on the sign, it says no glass, all pets on leash, no motorized vehicles, and no alcohol. And yet, several times on different parts of the trail, we've seen these two. People having their pets off leash, their pets going to the bathroom, and people not picking up after their pet, and cans of beer just thrown about. So folks, if y'all can correct that, that would be great. Otherwise, so far, this is a really great trail. Not difficult at all, really. It has been a walk so far. And then you get views like this.
Really beautiful out in this opening.
Mm-hmm. I was hoping we'd come across something like this. Yeah. I wonder what the temperature is right now. Time is 7 o'clock. Well, it says it's 94 and feels like 98, but feels more like in the 80s, huh?
Yeah.
Butterfly. Butterflies are everywhere.
They're like white with a little bit of bright orange on them.
Yep. Whoa. If I just activated the GoPro like a couple seconds earlier, well, we'll see. We'll see if I got it. The only thing is I can't zoom in. I think we are seeing for the first time in our lives lightning bugs.
Oh my god, they're so cool.
I really hope you can see these things, folks. Maybe switch to the, I'm gonna switch to the my phone. Well, sure enough, when we start recording, that's so cool. That was a first time experience.
Maybe we'll see some more. See them again.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah, that was pretty neat.
Straight. Remember that giant you had to hop over in Land of the Giants? Do you think you can hop over this?
No, no, why don't you show me how to hop over? Really?
Yeah.
Oh, come on. That wasn't a hop.
I don't need to hop. Crossing down here, back across the river, and back to the truck. All right, here's the final crossing, back to the truck. And that, folks, wraps up the Onion Creek Metropolitan Park and Greenbelt Trail. Not sure where exactly back there where the Knuckles crossing was or where the start of it was, but we got to get back to the truck. As you see, we're losing daylight. That's okay. Showed you most of Onion Creek so far. I think I might rate it a 4 out of 10 or 4 out of 5. What would you say?
Yeah. I mean, there's room for improvement here.
Mm-hmm.
But I love seeing the cactuses, hearing the loud noise from the cicadas.
Yeah.
Love all the variety of butterflies fluttering around along the trail. And lots of grasshoppers and crickets here. And there's little frogs and fishes along the creek. Yeah. So that's pretty neat. I didn't pick any onions.
Yeah, why do you call it Onion Creek Trail, I wonder? But it should come out to close to 4 miles, I think. Here at this last crossing, we are at Greenport 6-2, so maybe 4 miles, but we'll see at the end of the video. So thank you all for watching, and we are on to the next adventure tomorrow, Bull Creek Trail. Texas, when I'm far from home, and the cold winds blow, stuck out somewhere, folks I don't. Blowing through your hair. Well, come on, roll with me till the sun goes down. Texas sun. Texas sun.
Ooh, baby, you're so gorgeous. About you and me, take a little trip in the big body.
Take a ride with me, babe. You by my side. How does it sound? You and I. How does it sound? You and I.